you're watching Silicophilic, the home of all tech solutions. If you're getting the direct X function error while launching FIFA 23, then we know how to fix it. Watch this video till the end and learn how to solve it. Before we get into the solutions, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Also, like this video if it helps you solve this issue. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you are facing any issue while performing them. We also have a Facebook group of troubleshooting experts where you can share your tech issues and get direct help. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Now, let's jump into the solutions. Method 1. The first thing you can do is reinstall DirectX. Open the link in the description. You can also search for DirectX and open the Microsoft website ranked at the top from the Google search results. Click on the download button. After the download is complete, run the exe file. Click on Yes to allow the installation. Follow the on-screen instructions to finish the download process. Accept the license agreement and click on Next. From the Next window, uncheck the Bing bar box and click on Next to proceed. Let the installation process complete. After it is complete, restart your PC and then try to launch the game. Method 2. The next thing you can do is select debug mode in NVIDIA control panel if you have an NVIDIA graphics card. Right-click on your desktop. Select More options and then select NVIDIA control panel. Click on the Help tab from the top. Check debug mode from the options. Now launch the game. Method 3. The next thing you can do is reinstall the graphics drivers. Right-click on your Windows Start button and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics driver. Select Uninstall Device and follow as shown. After uninstalling the driver, reinstall it. For AMD graphics driver, you will need to install the Radeon app and run it. For NVIDIA graphics drivers, install the GeForce Experience. Running these apps will automatically detect the missing graphics drivers and download and install them. Once the drivers are installed, restart your computer. Method 4. If you're using a PC or laptop with both integrated and dedicated graphics, make sure that you run the game on the dedicated graphics card. To do that, type graphics settings in the Windows search box and press Enter. Click on the Browse button. Go to the FIFA 23 installation folder. Select the game exe file and click on Add. After the game is added, click on Options. Select High Performance and then Save. If you don't know where the FIFA 23 installation folder is, then open Steam and head to Library. Right-click on FIFA 23 and select Manage. Click on Browse Local Files. And this will open the installation folder. Note the address and use it to browse in the graphics settings. Method 5. You can also verify the integrity of the game files. Open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on FIFA 23 and open Properties. Go to the Local Files tab and select Verify Integrity of Game Files. Wait for Steam to finish verifying the game files. Then launch the game. Method 6. The next thing you can do is disable Steam overlay. Open Steam. Click on the Steam tab and select Settings. Go to In-game Settings. And check the box for Enable the Steam Overlay option. Method 7. You can also try playing FIFA 23 with low in-game graphics. For that, run FIFA 23 Launcher and click on Game Settings. Go to the Rendering Quality section and select the Low option. Method 8. The next thing you can try is disabling the full screen optimization for FIFA 23. Open FIFA 23's installation folder as shown earlier. Locate the FIFA 23 EXE file and right-click on it. Select Properties. Go to the Compatibility tab and check the Disable Full Screen Optimization box. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Method 9. Next, you can try tweaking the NVIDIA Control Panel settings. For that, open NVIDIA Control Panel. Click on Manage 3D Settings. Open Program Settings. Click on the drop-down menu. Find the game from here. If you do not find the game enlisted here, click on the Add button. Click on Browse and go to the Game Installation folder. Select the game .exe file and click on Open. Scroll to find OpenGL Rendering GPU. Select your graphics card from the adjacent list. Next, click on Power Management Mode and select Prefer Maximum Performance. Now click on Vertical Sync and select Adaptive. Click on Apply. Once you have changed all the above settings, launch the game. Method 10. If the issue persists, you can try different launching options for FIFA 23. Open Steam. Right-click on FIFA 23 and select Properties. In the Launch options, type -D3D11 and try to launch the game. If it doesn't work, then type -DX11 and then -DX12 commands. Method 11. Another thing you can try is closing any unnecessary apps running in the background. Right-click on the task bar and select Task Manager. In the Processes tab, check for any unnecessary processes. Right-click on any unnecessary process and select End Task to close them. You can close apps like Discord, Google Chrome, GeForce Experience, before playing FIFA 23. Method 12. You can also try updating your Windows. Type check for updates in the search bar and select the top result. Click on check for updates and wait for Windows to check for the latest available updates. Download and install the updates. Once done, restart your PC. Method 13. The last thing you can try is to uninstall and reinstall FIFA 23. Type control panel in the Windows search box and press enter. Select programs and features. Locate FIFA 23 and right-click on it. Select uninstall and follow as shown. Now install FIFA 23 and try to launch the game. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring out this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you are facing any issue while performing them. Also join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching Silicophilic.